Any idea what is SHARAN all about?
No.
Any idea?
Sanction for Health and Reconnection.
Wonderful, thank you. Yes, that's it's an acronym. It's Sanction for Health and Reconnection to Animal and Nature. And basically what we will be learning today is because we've been disconnected, that's why, you know, we're having all these hormonal issues, right? So I just quickly introduce you to Dr. Nandita Shah. She is a very unique doctor because she never gives you medicines. Okay, no prescriptions. You only prescribe food as medicine. She started SHARAN about 12 years ago and has been healing everybody through food. She's also won the Nari Shakti Puraskar, which is the highest civilian award for women in our country for the work that she's done. Thousands of people have actually been able to reverse or even prevent disease simply through a change of diet. And she's also a best-selling author of the book Reversing Diabetes in 21 Days. And I can go on and on and on, but let's get to the matter. And I'd like to invite Dr. to take care. Thank you.
So let's get on with the topic for today, which is hormonal havoc, which means so many hormonal issues are there. Can anybody tell me what hormonal issues we are facing today? Yes. What are the hormonal issues we are facing?
Insulin resistance.
Insulin resistance.
PCOD.
PMS. Thyroid. What else?
Early menstruations.
Early menstruation. Yeah. Premature puberty. What else?
Menopausal
problems. What else?
Premature
ovarian failure. Okay, what else?
Emotional disturbances
which can be related, and what else? Prostate enlargement. Right? So I made a list of the ones which were very common and we kind of covered them all except infertility. You know, India was a country of over-fertility. Now, there are infertility clinics everywhere. Isn't that something? Right? And then acne is connected with hormones as well. And vitamin D deficiency. Did you know that vitamin D is a hormone? And so many people are suffering from vitamin D deficiency these days. How many of you have checked your vitamin D levels? Okay, that's really great that so many of you have checked, and those who haven't, it's a good thing to check. And how many of you who have checked found them low? Yes, it's almost the same number, and that's because in Mumbai you cannot get vitamin D from the sun. The sun is the original source of vitamin D, but you need to get sunlight directly on the skin. The skin manufactures vitamin D through the action of the sunlight. And unfortunately, we have too much smog, so you can't get direct sunlight here. Are there any doctors amongst you all? Any doctors here? Okay, lovely. So, I'm, you know, always grateful to have doctors because it's my hope that what I'm doing spreads all over. So, you're my hope today. And if I make any mistakes, please correct. If you have anything to add, please do add. And any nutritionists here? Nutritionists? Okay, great. So one nutritionist and one doctor next to each other. Now I even recognize you. So thank you for coming. Okay. So hormonal problems. What are hormones? Does anyone know what hormones are? Okay. Yes.
Chemical reactions in our body.
Yeah. Hormones are chemical messengers. You know, our body contains many cells, lots of little cells all working together in close communication. And all this communication takes place with the help of hormones. Do you know which hormones there are in the body? Okay, you know, this is something that's a little bit too much and you don't really have to remember it. There are all kinds of hormones, so many different hormones. And we look into some of them. So there are these hormonal glands, and you know, this is not what you need to remember, because you don't need to remember which are the hormones and this and that. what you need to remember is what do you need to do to get free of hormonal problems. Okay? So if I mention a few hormones here and there, that's just so that you know what we're talking about. What you need to remember is what do I have to do to be well. Okay? So don't worry about all these big names. So these are various endocrine glands, and endocrine glands release hormones all over the body. And here are just a few hormones which are really important. There's the pituitary, which is the master gland. It actually orchestrates all the other hormones in the body. And then there's the hypothalamus, which regulates the temperature and other vital functions. And then there's the parathyroid, which regulates the calcium in the body. And sometimes when we have kidney diseases, then this goes out of balance too. And then we have the thymus, which regulates the immune system. Okay? And the pancreas, you all know that's insulin. And thyroid, you kind of know, it regulates metabolism. So when you have hypothyroid, less thyroid, then we tend to become fatter, more constipated. And when we have hyperthyroid, we tend to metabolize more and we feel more hot and moving around. Okay? And then there's the adrenal glands, which secrete cortisone. You know, this is important for our body. We secrete some. And then there's the pineal gland, which is connected to sleep. And the ovaries, which secrete estrogen mainly and progesterone, and they are connected to female reproduction, and testes, which secrete testosterone and are connected to male reproduction, right? Now, all these hormones get affected because, you know, the pituitary gland orchestrates them. When one hormone goes out of balance, all the others are affected. That means, you know, that's why we have so many people with PCOD and thyroid and diabetes and infertility. It all comes together kind of just because all the hormones are interconnected, right? Now, if we want to get rid of a hormonal problem, what do we have to do? If say, let's say we want to get rid of any problem, what do we have to do?
Go to the root cause.
Go to the root cause. And that's the big problem. You know, today when we have thyroid, hypothyroid, then we take thyroxine. That means what we're doing is just handling the symptoms. You understand? But what we are going to talk about today is what is the cause of thyroid deficiency. And if we can put our finger on that, and that's what we're going to do for all the other hormonal problems, because they're all interrelated. So we can do it all in one shot, kind of, you know. So if we can put our finger on that, that means actually understand the cause and remove the cause. Thyroid problem, diabetes problem, PCOD, breast cancer, all of these can decrease. And that's actually what SHARAN does, you know. Like, how you, some of you know what SHARAN does, right? Do you know that we have a 5-point plan? Anybody knows the 5-point plan? Yes?
It's the whole food.
Whole foods.
Plant-based.
Plant-based.
And organic food.
Organic food.
And check the deficiency for vitamin B12 and D.
Check and supplement vitamin B12 and D. Thank you very much, Smita. So, let me just explain this. Why are we eating a plant-based diet? You know, in nature, every animal should eat according to its species, right? If you have a lion, it'll eat meat. If you have a cow, it'll eat grass. Because animals eat by instincts. SHARAN stands for Sanctuary for Health and Reconnection to Animals' Nature. Are you hearing me? Do I really need this? Maybe. Okay. So SHARAN stands for Sanctuary for Health and Reconnection to Animals and Nature. That means why animals and nature? Because animals and nature know how to be well. And we don't. Animals and nature eat whatever they are supposed to eat. But we are brought up thinking that we are omnivores. Did that happen to you too? Okay. We are told that we are omnivores and that we can eat anything. But that's not quite true. Because we should eat what is in our instincts. Right? Imagine if you go to a farm or an orchard and you see fruits and vegetables. What do you feel like doing?
Plucking.
Now imagine if you see a chicken walk by, or a goat, or a cow. Does your mouth water?
No.
Now, whose mouth would really water if they saw a chicken walk by? Maybe a dog could pounce on a chicken and tear it apart and eat it whole. A dog would eat the chicken, skin, bones, blood, beaks, claws, everything. In fact, there are some animal lovers. They go to chicken shops in the night and take all the waste products and feed it to dogs. Because dogs can eat all the parts of chicken that we cannot eat. In fact, we cannot even eat chicken raw. We would get sick. So chicken is not our food. But we've learned to eat it. And that's the same with goats and cows, which may be lion food. A lion could eat a cow raw. But we can't. So it's not really our food. Are you getting what I'm saying? Now, you know, vegetarians and non-vegetarians get the same disease. And that's because meat and milk have the same properties, high protein, high fat and no fiber. But instinctively, we all love our mother's milk, right? If any of you are mothers, you know it, and fathers know it too, that every baby loves their mother's milk. But do they appreciate when we give them cow's milk? See, instinctively, we know that milk is not our food. But we are eating and living through culture, society, advertisements. Advertisements tell us all kinds of things. Yesterday I was giving a talk and somebody asked me, well, if you don't have milk, where do you get your
calcium?
Right? Where do you get your calcium? Now, who told us that we need milk for calcium?
Advertisements.
Why are they telling us these lies? Because they need to sell their product. Right? Now, think about it. Where does a cow get the calcium from?
Grass.
Right? Now, how many of us know somebody with calcium deficiency? How many of you know somebody with osteoporosis? Put your hand up. Okay, put it up high. All of you put up real high. Okay, and if you know the person you know wasn't consuming milk, then you can put your hand down, otherwise keep your hand up high. Can you see that all the people who have osteoporosis were anyway consuming milk? So how should we believe that milk is good for calcium? Correct? So, they are telling us something and we are believing it. When a lie is repeated often enough, it takes in our mind the form of truth. Right? We need meat for?
Protein.
And vegetarians need milk for that. Now, how many of you know somebody with protein deficiency? Protein deficiency. Put up your hands all the way up so I can see. Okay, great. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. And you're a doctor, so I'm not going to ask you. But what are the symptoms of protein deficiency? Can you tell me who has protein deficiency?
My husband.
Your husband. Very good. What are the symptoms of protein deficiency?
He's overweight.
He's overweight. Okay, what is protein good for? Why do we need protein?
Muscles.
Where did we learn that? From the gym trainer, right? Okay, so we need to figure out whether what they are telling us is true or because they want to sell whey protein. Right? Okay, so let's step back a few things. Who is a nutritionist? You're a nutritionist. So what is protein good for? Why do we need protein?
For the building of and repair of muscles,
where
and
where. Not muscles. It's the food for growth and repair. For growth and repair, not muscles. Where does the horse get the protein from? Certainly not whey protein, right? What is whey protein? What is it? What is whey? Come on, tell me, what is whey?
The top of the earth.
Yeah, it's the waste product from making paneer or cheese. You know, few years ago it was going in the garbage. Then someone got a good idea that let's sell it to these suckers for a high price. And they're making a lot of money and we're falling for it. Right? Okay, now, so we have to think, where does a horse get the protein from? What is protein good for? Protein is good for growth and repair. Now, obesity is a problem of overgrowth. So your husband definitely does not have protein deficiency, right? But we are told these things by various people, and unfortunately those people also get their information from the same place that we do, which is the advertisements, you know. So what are the symptoms of protein deficiency?
Muscular cramps.
Not at all. What do you take for muscular cramps? Did you take protein?
Not me, but there are friends who took protein powder and they took
protein powder and they got rid of muscular cramps. Oh my god.
No.
Okay, so there's a lot of misconceptions. But anyway, you know, those people who really know about protein, and there was one more in the back who put her hand up. What are the symptoms of protein deficiency?
I don't know, I just saw in my reports it came that.
In your reports, oh my. Okay, so look. Protein deficiency actually has a name. It's kwashiorkor or protein calorie malnutrition, and it only occurs in starvation or certain kidney problems. Am I right? So I have a doctor now backing me up, right? Please correct me if I'm wrong. So it only occurs in starvation, and since I know that your friends are not starved and nor is your husband, I am 100% sure that protein deficiency is not their problem. Okay, but we have been told protein, you need more protein, more protein, more protein. Actually, we have too many diseases of protein excess. That's another topic we won't get into right now. Okay, so the thing is that we have a lot of myths and misconceptions, and that's the reason we are so sick. So if we want to solve the problem, we have to understand what is the cause of hormonal problems, and I'm going to tell you that. Number one cause is other hormones, right? Because I told you that all the hormones are in balance. When one hormone goes out of balance, all the other hormones go out of balance. Then the second one is chemicals. Have you heard that chemicals are hormone disruptors, right? For example, if you walk into a room that has air freshener all the time going on, which happens sometimes in places in Bombay, you know, some five-star hotels also have that thing going on. So you sit in a Uber, sometimes it's going on. Now all this is chemicals. It causes hormone disruption. We'll talk about the whole list of chemicals later. And fat holds on to hormones, you know. They can't get taken out of the body properly because of fat, excess fat. So now we're going to look at what are the sources of hormones. Where are hormones coming into our body from to cause all this hormone disruption? So number one is medicines. We are taking hormones as medicines in the form of steroids, in the form of thyroid medicine. Sometimes we are getting overdosed as well, in the form of oral contraceptives. Do you know that oral contraceptives, which are hormones, actually change your whole hormonal state in the body so that you cannot conceive. And also when they do IVF, have you heard of IVF?
Yeah.
There also they pump in all sorts of hormones and then you don't feel healthy again. Takes a long time, right? And vitamin D, this is a medicine but it's also a hormone. So if you have excess vitamin D, that can also cause problems. And so you shouldn't have vitamin D without checking your levels. Should not have excess, right? Then animal products. Because like us, animals also secrete hormones, right? So if you have eggs, they are full of hormones. If you have milk, it's loaded with hormones. Milk is a secretion of a female mammal and it's loaded with estrogen, progesterone, growth hormone, prolactin, oxytocin. Some of these hormones we didn't even see in our list. So we are getting a dose of hormones with every glass and even some more which I'm soon going to tell you about, right? So if we have meat today, for example, or if we have chicken, you know those chickens in those cages that are going for slaughter, those broiler chickens, white ones, they are 6 weeks old, 42 days, and they are made to grow full size in 6 weeks, but a normal hen takes 12 weeks. Why are they made to grow full size in 6 weeks? Money, quick money, right? They go for slaughter in 6 weeks. All through hormones. So when we consume chicken, we are consuming hormones. When we consume eggs, chickens are made to lay 250 eggs a year. A normal chicken lays 25. How from 25 to 250? Hormones. Hormones is just one of the ways. There are other things also that happen. But hormones. So if we want the calf to grow fast so that it can go to the market, if we want the goats to grow fast so that it can go to the market, it's hormones. So when we consume animal products, it's hormones. Now, there's one more hormone that we all produce when we are stressed. Does anyone know what is a stress hormone?
Adrenaline.
Adrenaline. There are many also. Cortisol. So adrenaline. When we are stressed, we produce adrenaline. Now, if you see those chickens in the cages going for slaughter, you think they're having a ball? They are very stressed, right? They're huddling next to each other. They're scared to death. They know what's happening. They are full of adrenaline. When we consume chicken, we are consuming adrenaline. And have you seen that nowadays we are stressed too? Have you seen that?
Yes.
Stress, stress, stress. How many of you have never experienced stress? Okay, so you know what I'm talking about, right? So we are stressed too. And one of the reasons we are so stressed is because we're eating animal products. Okay, so that adrenaline goes to us and we're stressed. In fact, if you completely stop eating animal products, stress levels drop. Depression drops. People today are on antidepressants, right? Because of all these problems, because we are taking the hormones of very depressed animals. Think about milk. A cow is artificially inseminated. That's called rape. Every day in the newspaper you read about rape, but we're not reading about the endless rape of cows. Right? Actually, it's all coming back to us through the hormones, right? So cows are artificially inseminated so that they'll become pregnant when they're just 2 years old. That's when they can first conceive. And then when the baby is born, if it's a male calf, it's taken away from the mother. It goes to make calf leather, right? The cow is very distressed the cow is as attached to her baby as we are attached to ours. All those stress hormones in the milk, drink it up, right? So it's coming back to us. And nowadays, since we consume more milk than ever before, in the form of paneer or cheese or, you know, milk sweets. When I was young, milk sweets were for Diwali. Cheese wasn't in the market. And paneer was a way to rescue spoiled milk.
Yeah.
Is it true?
Yeah.
Nowadays, paneer is an item. Cheese is in every restaurant and every home also, right? So things have changed a lot and we all have hormonal issues. Every family. So this is the story of animal products. And then nowadays animals and plants, even plants, are injected with hormones to make them grow bigger. I'm just going to show you a video. Okay, so this is a video on the risk of hormone therapy. Actually, nowadays hormone therapy has become almost nil. Right? There was a time when people would take hormone replacement therapy, HRT. HRT was given left, right and center. Now it has come down a bit, right? I don't see so many patients. Has it come down? Yes. And the reason it's come down was because it was found that it causes cancers. Right? So this video was on that, but it's a little bit, let's say, technical. So I'm going to go forward. And okay. So, you know, we were talking about hormones and now chemicals. And you can see that when we consume foods which are full of hormones and chemicals, then we get hormonal problems. And that's why Sharan has a 5-point plan. Food should be plant-based because you get hormones from animals. Food should be whole. Whole because what is not whole? Sugar, oil, white rice, white flour, taking off the skin of vegetables or fruits. This makes it not whole. Every animal eats whole. But when we eat things which are not whole, we need to eat more. And then we put on weight. Like, has anyone eaten brown rice over here? Okay, fabulous, you guys are too good. And when you eat brown rice, how much do you eat compared to white rice?
Half.
Can you see that you just remove the skin of the rice? You need to eat double. Now, if you eat double the rice, you'll put on weight. Because you're eating food with less nutrient. Maximum nutrients is just under the skin. When we remove it, right? Now, why do we remove the skin? Sometimes just to make it taste better, like when we use oil or sugar, right? But sometimes we do it to fruits and vegetables because we think it has pesticides. But you can't peel away the pesticides because pesticides go right to the center. So even if you remove the skin, you still got pesticides. And that's why it's really important to have organic foods. Okay? So now you already saw some chemicals in our foods, the copper sulfate and the carbide. So what are the sources of chemicals that are making us sick? Number one source is the non-organic foods. Now I know that whenever I say this, people ask me, well, how do I know that organic is really organic?
All of you agree, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, how do we know that organic is really organic? Here's what I tell you. I can assure you that food in the market is 100% non-organic. It definitely has all the chemicals. Isn't it better? I'm sure that there's some golmaal because golmaal is happening everywhere. But isn't it better to have 80% organic than 100% chemical? Right? Now, if you really want to know whether your food is 100% organic, you've got to have your own farm. Or you can go to a farm and see what they, what's coming out of that farm. Like you can connect to your farmer. Just as you are interested in health, farmers are often interested in the health of the soil. They don't want to destroy their soil. They are thinking long term. There are farmers like this. And so they do keep their things really organic. So it is possible to get 100% organic, but we have to be vigilant, okay? And then packaged food. Packaged food, if you just look at the ingredients, you know it contains chemicals. Right? Because all the packages contain words we cannot even read. Have you seen? Then it's surely chemicals, right? And then plastics. You know, when you consume something from plastic, plastic has chemicals in it that leach into the food. Especially if you cook in plastic or put hot things in plastic or freeze in plastic, you know. So we have to be cautious about plastic. And then medicines. Medicines are chemicals. Sometimes we think that medicine is something good only, but it's not. If you look at the side effects of every medicine before you take it, you will be thinking, how can I take any medicine? Instead, people are thinking, how do I know it's organic? Do we ever ask our doctor, like, what are the side effects of this medicine before we take it? Right? And then personal care products. Have you ever seen the ingredients on your toothpaste? It's scary to put it in your mouth, right? But even the perfumes are absorbed through our skin. The hair dyes, the soaps, the shampoos, the deodorants, the lotions, and all the other potions. And then there's household chemicals. We are going to talk about all of these things, and finally the environmental chemicals too. Now all this chemical cauldron makes us get hormonal problems. So we have to minimize it, you know. Even if we are living in it, we have to minimize it. So all these processed foods, all these ready-made foods, supermarkets have lanes of them. And only one lane of real food, right? And these are the things that we should not eat. Now let's look inside what comes in all these foods. Today what we are having is a real big problem of plastic. Because every single thing we buy is in plastic. And then we have this mounting plastic, and luckily in Bombay plastic bags are not so prevalent. But we still have garbage collecting because of all the plastic bags, right? Did you see what happened to Juhu Beach? This is a recent photo. Yeah? So all this plastic is coming back to bite us. Whether it's in the landfills and our water goes through the plastic, and then the water contains PCBs, or the cows are eating, you know, nowadays there's no food for cows. So what will cows do? They go to the garbage, and all the organic waste is in a plastic bag. They eat the plastic plus the organic waste. So this plastic going into the cows comes back to us as PCBs. In the milk, there's PCBs in the milk. The real bad part is that when they go fishing, all the excess fish, the fish varieties which are not eaten by human beings, are ground up and sent to a rendering plant, dried up and fed back to cows, chickens and goats in our food chain as protein supplements. So all this plastic in the fish, whether you're vegetarian or not vegetarian, if you're consuming dairy, you're definitely getting it. Right? I just like this quote, so I put it up. Man is the most insane species. He worships an invisible god and slaughters a visible nature without realizing that this nature he slaughters is the invisible god that he worships. You know, we are polluting nature with every festival. Holi, pollution of nature. Ganesh Chaturthi, pollution of nature. Diwali, pollution of nature. I mean, I can go on. You know what I'm talking about, right? And all of this is destroying our health. We have hormonal problems. And then we must remember that medicines are chemicals too. And we are being over-medicated. In fact, they say that in the US, all the water, tap water, contains medicines. Now, if it happens in the US, I can't imagine that it's not true in India too, you know. Because the cycle of water is, the medicines go out through the urine, it goes back into the water cycle, it comes back down. And so we are having chemicals. And if you drink municipal water, there's chlorine in it as well, you know. So chemicals in medicines, and then personal care products, all of these things have chemicals, and all of these things have bad effects. So if you just check out, and we don't have too much time for this, so we won't do it now, but you could do it once you're home. Just look at the bottle of shampoo, look at your bottle of perfume, look at your deodorant, and see the ingredients, right? So all of these have ingredients that have serious side effects. And we don't really recognize it because we don't think that our skin can absorb all these chemicals. And then home care products, you know, all of these things. Actually, the BBC said that people who clean have poorer lung function just because they're breathing all those things that we are using to clean all the time. The acids and the phenyls and all those things. And you can find this right now on the internet. So certain things we should also avoid in our kitchen. Aluminum. Aluminum, including cooking in aluminum foil, because the aluminum leaches into the food. Then non-stick. Non-stick is coated with Teflon. That Teflon leaches, causes hormonal problems. And microwave doesn't really cause hormonal problems, but I stuck it in here because it harms our food. It does reduce the nutrient value, so you need to eat more. So it increases the fat. And so now we're coming to fat. And fat we get through oil, butter, ghee, and you said that you had attended cooking classes, right? You had attended cooking classes, and you know very well that our cooking classes are zero oil. And the food is good?
Tasty, yummy.
Yummy. The food is delicious, right? So why do we need to eat oily food? Oil doesn't even taste good. Have you ever tasted oil? So oil doesn't even taste good. Why do we have to eat oily food when we can eat delicious food without oil and reduce our weight like so many of them did and get free of hormonal problems too? All animal products are full of fat and you can't take it out. You boil milk, fat on top, boil chicken, fat on top, boil fish, fat on top. Everything is full of fat. And it also lacks fiber, so it causes a lot of problems. So we really need to avoid animal products. Now, milk. It's really hard to believe. That it's bad, right?
Yeah.
It's really hard to believe that it's bad, right?
It's very hard to believe.
Very hard to believe. Because it's white. And our mothers ran around us for half an hour and so it's got into our brain that why would my mother run if it wasn't good for me? And so when we grow up, we do the same to our kids. Our kids tell us, it's not good for me. Just like a lion would say, if you gave it grass to eat, it's not good for me. But we believe it's good, right? And most people say, oh, I don't drink milk. I don't like milk. So we make milk into other things that we can enjoy, like curds, paneer, cheese, ice cream, etc. Right? So what's wrong with milk? Number one, fat. We already spoke about that. Then hormones. Milk is full of hormones. Then pus. Every glass of milk contains pus because the udders of cows are meant for baby calves, and if human hands or milk machines are milking them, they are always injured, inflamed, indurated, blood and pus in the milk. Now, in order to control that, cows are given antibiotics in their food. You know, 80% of the antibiotics produced in the world are fed to animals in our food chain. 80%. Now, you know, doctors often say to a mother, a lactating mother, don't take medicines. It will go to the baby. But every day in our glass of milk, we are having antibiotics, which is why we are also facing the problem of antibiotic resistance. Right? Because we are having antibiotics, when we need them, they don't work. And then in the past, milk had earthworms. You know, in those aluminum containers going in the hot weather, how come the milk doesn't spoil? They used to put earthworms. Nowadays, they put urea. Now, urea is a fertilizer, and consuming urea causes kidney disease. Have you seen the number of kidney disease cases that are growing these days? Kidney problems and dialysis and kidney transplant, and one of them we already saw was copper sulfate causes this problem because every single medicine chemical that we put in our body is broken down by the liver and excreted by the kidneys. Every single chemical is a load on the liver and kidneys. And that's why sometimes when we go for our reports, the SGOT, SGPT, some liver function tests are high, and then the creatinine and the urea and whatnot, kidney function tests are also high. Right? And then milk contains a concentration of pesticides. Why? Because the cows are not fed organic food. Now, if a cow needs to eat 12 kilos of something to give you 1 liter of milk, all the pesticides are concentrated in the milk. And milk contains more pesticides, and so does meat, than any plants, any fruits or vegetables. So if you're scared of non-organic fruits and vegetables, you should be double scared of animal products. Because animals are higher on the food chain. Did you follow what I meant by that? Okay. So cows, these days, they're grazing like this. Unfortunately. But whether they eat blades or sanitary ware or toilet paper or garbage, it's all coming back to us through the milk. Right? This shows plastic bags removed by operation from a cow. And up to 85 kilos can be found in a live cow. 85 kilos of plastic. Plastic is so light. Right? So, but it's all coming back to us through the milk too. If you want to understand more about this, there's a very good film on YouTube called The Plastic Cow. The Plastic Cow is made in India and it talks about the plastic that is coming in our milk. Actually, they've tested milk for PCB. PCB is a breakdown of plastic. Okay. And then it also contains rendered products. Rendered products because all the slaughterhouse byproducts are ground up. Also the fish, the excess fish, are all ground up, dried up and fed back to cows. And therefore, we are getting... Now this means that when you go to a slaughterhouse and 85 kilos or 65 kilos of plastic is in the stomach, but nobody eats stomachs of cows, It all goes to the rendering plant. Nobody looks inside that stomach. It gets dried up, plastic and all, and fed back to cows. So the plastic is increasing year by year in the food chain. Are you following what I'm saying? And then stress, we already spoke about stress. Now, as if this wasn't enough, 65% of the milk in India is adulterated. Now this comes in every newspaper. And we are sipping our chai while reading it, right? Not really thinking about the connection. So let's see it now. Can you imagine that this is there on YouTube in every single language in India? Because all the TV channels have shown it. You can find it on the internet and newspapers also. It is coming again and again. And some people say 65%, some people say 55%, and some say 85%. It's all the same, right? We are consuming all of this. So, then the question comes, what about organic milk? Okay, now honestly, every animal produces milk only for their young, and we are not cows. So just as dog's milk is for puppies, cow's milk is for calves, and in nature no animal drinks another animal's milk. That means goats don't drink pig's milk or monkeys don't drink elephant's milk, right? We are the only species that drinks another animal's milk, and that too after infancy. So we don't need milk. We have been told we need milk. So people say, okay, instead of milk, what shall I have? Soya milk? Almond milk? No, we don't need milk. If you want to have soya milk or if you want to have almond milk, that's better, but we don't need any milk. Okay? So what about organic milk? Now organic milk is very good, but only for organic cows. Right? If you are not one, do not consume it. Okay? So it also contains fat, it also contains hormones, it also contains pus. So no point drinking organic milk, right? And A1 and A2. A2 milk also. You should not consume A2 milk. A2 milk is for A2 cows. Organic milk is for organic cows, and we are none of them. Right? So all of these are hormone disruptors. Hormone-filled foods, then plastic-laden foods, non-organic foods, personal care products, household chemicals, and environmental chemicals. Environmental chemicals means what we have in Bombay. Now we can't do anything about it. So at least let us do things about all the others which we can do a lot about. We are so lucky that we are in Bombay, that we can get organic foods, which sometimes if you go to the villages you can't get. Because one farmer is growing tomatoes, one farmer is growing peas. How will you get everything from any one farmer, you know? Okay. So now, common hormonal issues, we'll just talk a bit about these very common ones. Hypothyroid is very common. Hypothyroid means that the thyroid gland is not producing enough thyroid, and the TSH, which comes from the pituitary gland, the TSH is a thyroid stimulating hormone. It tries to stimulate the thyroid to produce more, becomes too high, right? And when you have hypothyroidism, you get thinning of hair, puffiness of face, maybe enlarged thyroid, you don't see that so much these days. Constipation, dryness of the skin, feeling cold, poor memory, so many symptoms of hypothyroid. You know, hypothyroid must be treated. It should not be left like, okay, I'll wait till my thyroid levels come down. No, it must be treated right away. But once you start the treatment, you can start removing all the causes of hypothyroid. Now this time I just came back from 21 day program, and three people, we do all the tests in the beginning and we do all the tests at the end, and three people, their TSH levels fell so much that I had to reduce the thyroid, the thyroxine by the end of the program, right? So when you remove all the chemicals, all the food in our 21 day program is 100% organic, plus we're doing it in a very eco-friendly place. So automatically people start getting well. PCOD means that the ovaries have multiple cysts. The ovaries are trying to produce more, but it's not really working. And so the cyst gets enlarged, and menstrual problems and infertility and so on. And then menopausal, there's so many problems of menopause, but actually if you're on plant-based diet, nobody suffers from menopausal problems. Imagine, right? And prostate enlargement, when the prostate enlarges, it blocks the ureter. You know, the urine can't come out easily. And so they strain for urination, it takes a long time. And honestly, no one on a plant-based diet suffers from prostate problems. So we can all stop suffering from all these problems or prevent them, and especially in our children, right? Now, I often get asked this question, what about soy? Is soy harmful, right? Who told us that soy is harmful?
Internet, advertisement.
Gym instructors, God forbid.
My gynec, she suggested
your gynec. You see, but unfortunately, because I'm a doctor too, and you're a doctor, so she also probably knows, doctors don't get nutrition education, right? So they are picking up nutrition information the same way we are. This is all over the internet. But who is spreading this message? Why would some... Now we have to think, huh? We have to think. What is soy? Soy is just... Have you ever seen soy?
Yes.
Looks like a big tur dal. Nothing more. Right? It's not something big. How can it be so deadly? Actually, phytoestrogens are there in all these things, even in cornflakes. But the reason they talk about soy is because soy has competitor. Soy is a competitor, right? Actually, soy, maximum amount of soy is fed to animals in our food chain. I mean, 90% of the soy is fed to animals in our food chain. How many of you are eating soy every day? Nobody. Right? 90% of the soy is fed to animals. If you're consuming milk, you're consuming soy indirectly, right? But it's not harmful because phytoestrogen is not estrogen. It doesn't cause thyroid problem, it doesn't cause breast cancer, doesn't cause any problem, okay? So in summary, hormonal problems are caused by hormones, fat and chemicals. Chemicals in plastic are hormone disruptors. Hormonal treatments can also cause problems. If you have too much vitamin D, you can have problems. Okay? So we need to reduce and eliminate chemicals in our food and environment. And phytoestrogens are not harmful, and soy is not a bioweapon. Okay? Nothing wrong with soy. But in the same way as you may have tur dal twice a week, you shouldn't have soy, every day soy, right? We definitely don't need more proteins. So we don't need to do something special to get more protein. You understand? Okay. Now, what can we do to prevent all these hormonal problems? Follow Sharan's 5-point plan. Plant-based, whole, organic, Actually, we have a list of where to buy organic on our website. So if you go to Try Vegan, there's city directories. There if you go to Mumbai, where all you can get organic is written. And vitamin B12 and vitamin D. Then reduce the chemicals in your life. Don't use chemicals that you don't need. We are using plenty, right? Like, why are we using so much perfume and deodorant? Because we're stinking. Why are we stinking? Because we're eating decaying foods. Once we start eating our natural foods, we'll stink less. Right? So we have to clean up from inside out. Right? Minimize the medications. And that's what we help you do. All the Sharan doctors during consultations help to reduce your medications so that you can be free of medications one day. And in our 21-day program, many people got free of all their medications. Some people went back with some of their medications. But honestly, people did walk in with somewhere close to 20, 24, 26 medications. So then they will go out with four. But I'm just saying that medicines can be reduced pretty quickly. And look for happiness, not pleasure. Like, why do we go to a restaurant to eat? It's momentary pleasure, right? Do you feel more cheerful after eating in a restaurant? No. So how can we look for real happiness? So reversing disease requires a shift in consciousness. Because we are living in a culture where everyone is eating out. It's really hard to believe that eating out can be so bad if everyone is doing it. Sometimes you say, okay, let me have a little, everyone's eating. So what happened to me? Right? But as a doctor, I know everyone is getting sick. It's pretty scary, you know. Okay. But not just as a doctor. See, I don't do cooking classes so much anymore, but I used to do cooking classes and I used to do them in restaurants. You know, because restaurant has all the equipment and you can do cooking class for lots of people and all that. It stopped me from eating in restaurants. Because when you go inside the kitchen of a restaurant, then you really don't want to eat there anymore. So what do we do as Sharan? For those of you who are new to Sharan, we do all kinds of talks and even specific seminars like reversing diabetes or hypertension or osteoporosis and various seminars. And then we have consultations. We have doctors and nutritionists. So if you're not on any medicine, you can take a nutritional consultation to help you get on the path, right? And then we have publications, and some of them are free on our website. So you just go to About Us publications, and then you can download free PDFs. So start reading. Our website is also full of information. And then we have a 6-week weight loss health gain weight loss program. I wrote it correctly. Health gain weight loss, because weight loss is a byproduct. You gain health, weight loss happens, right? Automatically. So we never think about weight loss. So 6 weeks, people get together once a week for 6 weeks, and they learn the whole process, and during those 6 weeks they even get better. And then cooking classes, we have all kinds of cooking classes. How many of you have attended our cooking classes? Okay, fabulous, fabulous. So you know that so many things can be made healthy way, right? And then of course we have the 21 day health retreat. And why do we have a 21 day health retreat? I want to tell you that nobody needs to come there. Because you can get all that information just by this done, right? But 21-day health retreat is just an experience. Once you experience it, you can never forget it, right? It takes 21 days to change your habit, and you see lab tests improving in just 21 days. So you recognize how much your body is able to heal in a short time, right? Now, I just want to lead you, guide you through our website. If you go to our website homepage, you will see all kinds of events. And if you go to the bottom of that, it will say see all events. And if you go here, it says book a consultation with a doctor or a nutritionist. So you can just click there and you will get all the information of how to book a consultation. And we also support you through Facebook. And we have an organic, you're so lucky here in Mumbai, we have an organic farmers market. And if you go there, you'll meet people who are following Sharan lifestyle. So it gives a lot of information, you know. And then we have all kinds of events and cooking classes and talks. You know, there's one talk about how I reverse my IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. Because so many people have that problem too. Okay? And I'm just going to tell you two important programs that are coming up. The rest you can see here on our website. But two important programs that are really useful is on the first of every month, every first, we have a basic cooking class. What does basic cooking class teach? How to make curds without milk. How to make cheese without milk. How to make ice cream without milk. Now, those of you who are having lunch here, you will taste some of this today, okay? So that's what it teaches. It also teaches you how to cook a good dry sabzi without oil. How to start the day with a green smoothie. So various different things it teaches you so that you are equipped to start cooking in your home, okay? How to do tadka without oil, how to fry onions without oil, all that. Now, once you do that, you can go for advanced, like how to make pakoras without oil. You can learn all those things, how to make samosas without oil. All of that can be done, right? And then there's 6 weeks to health gain and weight loss. Now, why is that good? Because just like in the 21-day program, it's really good to do things in a group, you know? And when you do it in a group, each person is inspiring the other and we all get the results, right? Okay, so basically that's all I want to share with you today. But I want to thank you all for being here. And here's what I say, do as much as you can, learn, keep learning more and get all the results.